Hello again, and I will now talk about the final section of this webinar, which focuses on the autoclave and the ultra-low temperature, or the ULT, freezer research studies. These research projects can also be referred to as water and energy efficiency studies, respectively. These studies are currently work in progress. I will first begin with the autoclave study, discuss some of our research goals, talk about the differences between medical grade and research grade autoclaves, and share some key insights from a past comparison study conducted by Delphine Foguereau, who previously worked with the Office of Sustainability. Laboratories tend to use a lot of water. Cage washers, autoclaves, deionized water, and single pass cooling all contribute to the substantial water requirements of many labs. Did you know that it takes 3 gallons of water to make 1 gallon of deionized water? To put things into perspective, that's at least 3 gallons of water for every gel you run. Autoclaves can use as much as 60 gallons of water per cycle. Autoclaves provide a physical method for disinfection and sterilization. They work with a combination of steam, pressure, and time. They're used to decontaminate certain biological waste and sterilize media, instruments, and labware. Autoclaves and sterilizers are a necessity in the lab, but most labs may be equipped with large autoclaves, which are often oversized for the needs of the lab or the building. Our autoclave study goals revolves around the following questions. Number one, what is the frequency of usage of autoclaves on the UCR campus? Two, how much water do these autoclaves consume? And three, what are some of the more efficient options? In order to answer these questions, we may briefly look at some of the key differences between medical grade and research grade steam sterilizers or autoclaves. Medical grade autoclaves are high throughput workhorses designed for near constant 24-hour operation. Since speed is vital to hospital operations, medical grade units are rarely permitted to fully cool and they never shut down. But a design intended for 24/7 high throughput operation has to make trade-offs, and one of the biggest is water consumption. For their intended purpose, constant operation and high throughput sterilization, medical grade sterilizers are excellent devices. But what are the alternatives for education, research, and industrial labs uninterested in sending so many gallons of water needlessly down the drain? In contrast to their medical cousins, research grade autoclaves are designed for intermittent use. They do not need to be kept warm, do not require a constant flow of water to provide cooling, and will not be harmed if they're completely shut down for an hour, a night, a week, or even a year. While large medical grade steam sterilizers will continue to be the gold standard in demanding high throughput hospital sterilization, most laboratories are going to find themselves better served by the newer, more efficient research grade steam autoclaves. In summary, heavy duty medical grade autoclaves in research labs maximize water and energy consumption, posing a threat to the environment. Therefore, we conducted a study proposing the Prioclave, a light-duty research-grade steam autoclave, which is an ideal fit for research labs and educational institutions. This eco-friendly version minimizes the number of sterilization cycles, consumes energy only relative to usage, and estimates 81% energy savings in kilowatt hours per day and 93% water savings in gallons per day. Our study aims to track the energy metrics of the conventional medical grade autoclaves and convince laboratory personnel to switch to the newer, cost and energy efficient Prioclave without interrupting ongoing scientific research. By design, the Prioclave can be easily turned off and limits energy and water waste. Because of this feature, it requires a 30-minute warm-up time and runs are by default slightly longer than other typical autoclaves such as the Steris autoclave. The Office of Sustainability conducted an autoclave study for 1 year from 2 autoclaves on campus, one in the genomics building and one in the entomology building. Data was collected for energy and water consumption, as well as the number of cycles run per day. This was gathered from user log sheets. The water and energy usage of the Prioclave were also live recorded. This Prioclave was installed in the new EHNS, which is the Environmental Health and Safety Building, in April 2016. And since its installation, 22 runs have been measured. As depicted on this slide, there is a significant difference between the two types of autoclaves. On an average, the Steris is significantly higher in terms of both energy and water consumption when compared to the environment-friendly Prioclave. These statistics help us convince laboratories to shift to more eco-friendly appliances and get rid of old lab equipment, which are both a financial burden as well as unsustainable. Another research project is the ULT, or the Ultra Low Temperature Freezer Study. This study is relatively newer and we're in the process of gathering data. Did you know that ultra low temperature freezers can use as much energy as an average household every day? ULT freezers typically have a temperature range of minus 45 degrees Celsius to minus 86 degrees Celsius and are used for the storage of drugs, enzymes, chemicals, viruses, bacteria, cell preparations, tissue samples, and others. The general steps for this research study include identification of the 10 oldest ULTs from the campus inventory list. The next step would include identifying the Energy Star ULTs on campus. Essentially, similar to the autoclave study, we would like to draw a comparison study between the old models of ULTs versus the more energy efficient solutions, such as the Energy Star appliances. This would include tracking energy metrics of the two different systems in order to draw conclusions and yearly estimates of energy consumption between the two models. In regards to the ULT study, I would also like to promote the concept of minus 70 is the new minus 80. Chilling up your ultra low temperature freezer from minus 80 degrees Celsius to minus 70 degrees Celsius has two major benefits. Number one, it can reduce energy consumption by 30 to 40%. And in doing so, it can prolong the life of your freezer. This means less downtime and less chance that your samples will be compromised. A follow-up question to this might be, is it safe to store samples at minus 70 degrees Celsius? In the majority of cases, the answer is a definite yes. Nucleic acids can be safely stored at minus 20 C or minus 70, depending on how long they need to be stored. And most proteins can definitely be stored at minus 70. Bacteria and viruses are also generally safe at minus 70. In fact, 15 years ago, all ULT freezers were set to minus 65 degrees Celsius or minus 70 degrees Celsius. Further evidence backing this claim can be found at mygreenlab.org. Some other universities such as CU Boulder, UC Davis, Harvard, Dartmouth, and UC Santa Barbara were among the first in the United States to adjust their ULT freezer set points. Renowned companies such as AstraZeneca, Charles River Labs, Genentech, the CDC, Imperial College London, and NUI Galway have set their ULT freezers to minus 70 degrees Celsius. This brings us all to the end of the webinar. Thank you all for your patience and enthusiasm toward reaching a more sustainable future. This is just a glimpse of what the Office of Sustainability has to offer. For more information, please visit our website and feel free to contact us. In light of the current COVID-19 situation, we hope this recorded webinar encourages questions. Please email us your questions and we will be happy to get back to you. Thank you all once again.